Welcome to my video tutorial on histology of small intestine. Small intestine has got three parts, duodenum, jejunum and ileum. So we will be looking into the details of histological features of these three parts. Wall of the small intestine composed of four layers. They are from within outside, mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa and serosa. Mucosa being innermost layer composed of three layers, innermost epithelium supported by loose connective tissue called lamina propria, which further supported by thin layer of smooth muscles known as muscularis mucosa. So the mucosa composed of three layers further, epithelium, lamina propria and muscularis mucosa. Let's see the features of mucosa. Here is the wall of small intestine with the innermost layer mucosa, which lines the lumen. It is thrown into larger folds, which are seen as circular folds within the lumen. Here is the HND stained slide showing the larger folds formed by mucosa. They are called as plicae circularis. They look like valves, so they are also called as valves of Kerkring. So the plicae circularis are nothing but mucosal infoldings into the lumen of small intestine. Let's focus on one plica circularis. Here is the HND stained tissue focusing one plica, which is actually formed by underlying submucosal projection into the lumen so that the mucosa covering it is thrown into fold. So each plica is composed of mucosa and submucosa seen in its center. Further, the epithelial layer of mucosa is thrown into folds because of underlying lamina propria projections. Such projections are called villi. Each villus is formed by epithelium and lamina propria within its center. Let's focus on the villus. It's a finger-like projection formed by surface epithelium and lamina propria within its core. Here is HND stained tissue showing villi with their epithelium and lamina propria. The epithelium is formed by simple columnar cells and goblet cells. Goblet cells are mucus secreting cells and columnar cells act as absorptive columnar cells. Columnar cells on their luminal surface show microvilli, which are parallelly arranged surface projections equal in length so that they are seen as striations on the luminal surface of epithelium forming striated border. So the epithelium of small intestine is described as absorptive columnar epithelium with striated border along with few goblet cells. They are also known as enterocytes. The lamina propria of each villus composed of loose connective tissue, plasma cells and blood vessels, nerve fibers and a blind lymphatic channel which begins at the tip of the villus known as lacteale. So each villus seen on plica circularis of small intestine composed of simple columnar epithelium with striated border along with goblet cells. Within its core, lamina propria supported by loose connective tissue, plasma cells, blood vessels, nerve fibers and lacteal. Mucosa of the small intestine seen between the villi shows invaginations into underlying lamina propria. Such invaginations are known as crypts of Lieberkühn, which form intestinal glands. They are tubular in shape, seen externally as mucosal pits, from where surface epithelium dips into the crypt and lines the crypt of Lieberkühn. The cells lining the crypt of Lieberkühn are columnar cells, goblet cells, enteroendocrine cells and Paneth cells. All such cells are given off from intestinal stem cells, which are seen at the bottom of the crypt. Functionally, columnar cells are absorptive in function, goblet cells secrete mucus, enteroendocrine cells are also called as enterochromaffin cells or argentaffin cells. One of the examples for enteroendocrine cells here are APUT cells, amine precursor uptake decarboxylation cells. They secrete amines which have endocrine in function. Paneth cells, they are rich with zinc. They are eosinophilic granules as seen in their cytoplasm which secrete lysozymes. So the stem cells give rise to functionally two types of cells, absorptive and secretory cells. So that crypt of Lieberkühn is nothing but intestinal tubular glands. Here is the H&D stain slide under high power showing bottom of the crypt. Here are the absorptive columnar cells. Here is stem cell. Here is the goblet cell. And here is APUT cell, example for enteroendocrine cell. Here are the Paneth cells, which are seen at the bottom of the crypt, identified by their eosinophilic granules in their cytoplasm. So the mucosa of small intestine shows few characteristic features, which are points of identification for small intestine and differentiate it from large intestine. They are plicae circularis or valves of Kerkring, which are formed by submucosa and mucosa. Villi, they are finger-like projections seen throughout the mucosa formed by epithelium and lamina propria. Microvilli, they are surface projections of columnar epithelium. Such projections seen on the mucosa of small intestine, they increase the surface area, which helps in absorption. Further, mucosa undergoes indentations known as crypts of Lieberkühn or intestinal glands. Such characteristic features of mucosa are similar for duodenum, jejunum and ileum with minute differences. They are plicae circularis are seen more in number in duodenum, whereas villi are seen more in number in ileum, which means plicae decrease in number from duodenum to ileum, villi increase in number from duodenum to ileum. Let's see the composition of mucosa. It has three layers: epithelium, lamina propria, muscularis mucosa from inside to outside. Epithelium is composed of simple columnar epithelium, which is absorptive in function, having striated border with goblet cells. The lining epithelium also forms intestinal glands in the form of crypts of Lieberkühn. Lamina propria is composed of blood vessels, nerve fibers and lymphatic channels in the form of lacteals in each villus. Apart from that, aggregation of lymphocytes are also seen in the lamina propria in the form of lymphatic nodules, which are solitary single nodules in jejunum, whereas they aggregate to form pious patches in ileum. Such lymphatic nodules are absent in duodenum. Muscularis mucosa, formed by smooth muscles which are arranged in two layers, inner circular and outer longitudinal. Moving on to the next layer, submucosa. Here is the HND stained slide showing wall of the small intestine. Here is the mucosa with plica circularis, villi and intestinal glands. Here is the submucosa, which is composed of loose connective tissue with blood vessels, nerve fibers and lymphatic channels, which enters into plica circularis. In case of duodenum, submucosa is filled with mucus glands, which are tubulo-alveolar glands. Ducts of these glands penetrate the muscularis mucosa and open into bottom of crypts of Lieberkuhn or intestinal glands. Such mucus glands, which are seen in the duodenum, are called as Brunner's glands. These are absent in jejunum and ileum. Let's see the features of outermost layers, muscularis externa and serosa. Here is the HND stained tissue of small intestine showing four layers of its wall. From inside to outside, mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa and serosa. Muscularis externa is made up of smooth muscles which are arranged in two layers, inner circular layer and outer longitudinal layer. Serosa is made up of loose connective tissue with nerve fibers, blood vessels. It is nothing but visceral peritoneum grossly. The nerve fibers form plexuses within the wall, which are seen between inner circular layer and outer longitudinal layer of muscularis externa. Here they are called as myenteric plexus of nerves, which are also seen between submucosa and inner circular layer. Here it is called as Meissner's plexus. Such nerve plexuses, myenteric and Meissner's, supply smooth muscles, connective tissue and intestinal glands. The histological composition of three parts of small intestine is similar, but few features make them differentiate from each other. So let's see the differences between duodenum, jejunum and ileum histologically. Here are the villi in duodenum, which are tongue-shaped villi with their broad tip and narrow base. In jejunum, they are cylindrical in shape, whereas in ileum, they are leaf-shaped villi with their conical tip. Villi from duodenum to ileum increase in their number and decrease in their length, which means duodenum has lengthy villi, whereas ileum has shorter villi, which are more in number. Coming to lamina propria, which shows aggregation of lymphocytes in the form of lymphatic nodules, which form solitary nodules in case of jejunum, and aggregatory lymphatic nodules are seen in ileum in the form of Peyer's patches. Such collection of lymphocytes are not seen in the lamina propria of duodenum. The epithelial cells lining the Peyer's patches in the ileum, they act as antigen presenting cells or APC cells. In submucosa, duodenum shows aggregation of mucus glands known as Brunner's glands, which are not seen in jejunum and ileum. So these are the differentiating features of three parts of small intestine. Now it's time to see the HND stained slides of three parts of small intestine. Let's begin with the duodenum. Here is the HND stained slide of duodenum seen under low power. Here is the mucosa with villi and intestinal glands. Here is the muscularis mucosa and here is the submucosa with Brunner's glands. Here is the muscularis externa and here is the lightly stained serosa. Now let's see how to draw the duodenum tissue with H&E stain. In mucosa, villi should be drawn as tongue shaped with their broad tip and narrow base. They are lined by columnar epithelium with goblet cells, showing microvilli on their luminal surface forming striated border. Lamina propria, which takes up less amount of eosin as it is formed by loose connective tissue, and it should be drawn with few blood vessels lined by endothelium and nuclei of fibroblast cells. The epithelium from villi dips into lamina propria to form tubular intestinal glands or crypts of Lieberkühn. Because of their direction, in cross-section they may be found as alveoli lined by columnar cells. Muscularis mucosa. Smooth muscle cells should be drawn, forming two layers, inner circular and outer longitudinal, which is not shown here. The smooth muscle fibers, they traverse through the lamina propria and reach villus till their tip. Functionally, when it contracts, it decreases the height of the villus so that local mixing of the food material happens in the lumen of small intestine. Coming to submucosa, which takes up less amount of eosin, in which tightly packed mucous glands should be drawn. The submucosa should be filled by Brunner's glands in case of duodenum. Muscularis externa, the smooth muscle cells should be drawn in two layers, inner circular and outer longitudinal, which should be bounded by a thin layer of serosa. Moving on to jejunum. Here is the H&E stained slide of jejunum seen under low power. Here is the mucosa showing cylindrical shaped villi with intestinal glands. Here is the muscularis mucosa, submucosa, here muscularis externa and here lightly stained serosa. Now let's see how to draw the jejunum tissue with H&E stain. In mucosa, villi should be drawn as cylindrical shaped, lined by columnar cells and goblet cells, showing microvilli. Lamina propria takes less amount of eosin, with capillaries lined by endothelium and few fibroblast nuclei. Intestinal glands should be shown close to the muscularis mucosa in the form of alveoli. Muscularis mucosa should be drawn similar to duodenum but entering into plica circularis here, along with submucosa, which takes less amount of eosin, with blood vessels lined by endothelium and nuclei of fibroblasts. Muscularis externa should be drawn similar to the duodenum, inner circular and outer longitudinal, with serosa, with mesothelium. Let's see the ileum H&E stained slide under low power. Here is the mucosa showing shorter leaf shaped villi. In lamina propria, there are aggregations of lymphatic nodules forming Peyer's patches, because of which muscularis mucosa is interrupted and submucosa becomes thin. Here is the muscularis externa and here is the serosa. Let's see how to draw the ileum with H&E stain. In mucosa, the villi should be drawn shorter and leaf-shaped, lined by columnar cells and goblet cells with microvilli. In lamina propria, eosin-stained loose connective tissue with blood vessels lined by endothelium, fibroblast nuclei and collections of lymphocytes in the form of lymphatic nodules, where the lymphocytes are tightly packed at periphery, and in the center of the nodule they are less in number, so that a nodule is lightly stained in the center, and in the periphery it is densely stained with hematoxylin. Intestinal glands should be shown within the lamina propria. Muscularis mucosa, similar to duodenum and jejunum, sending the fibers into the villi. Submucosa is thinner compared to duodenum and jejunum, takes less amount of eosin, with blood vessels and fibroblast nuclei. Muscularis externa, similar to duodenum and jejunum, along with serosa, which is lined by mesothelium. Here is the end of this video. Thanks for watching.